Well, when they were little kids, you know, I would buy them go-karts and they'd ride them for a few days, and then they'd want to go play stick and ball and soccer and baseball and football, all the stuff kids should do and need to do. And I'm really happy that they got to do that when they were young. And when Ty turned 13 years old, I think he's 2 years younger than Austin. Austin was about 15. And I bought him those go-karts. I said, look, last one I bought, I said, if y'all ever decide you want to go racing, let me know. Well, Ty called me and he said, Pop, you said, if we ever want to go racing, give you a call. Austin and I talk, we want to go racing. That was the most expensive phone call I've had. But we took them and went down here, bought a couple of Bandolier cars went to the racetrack. Boy, they didn't do very good at all. And I said, well, this ain't gonna take too long. And we go back in a couple of weeks and test a little track there at Charlotte. And man, it's like a light switch went on in both of them. They both went out there and was really fast and could drive the cars. So we carried them to the race and they started winning races and moved them to legend cars. They won races and I wanted to see them drive dirt because that'll find out if you have good car control. Both of them won a lot of races on dirt. And then we moved Austin to ARCA, K&N. Both of them ran K&N, won races, and then we moved them to ARCA. And I don't think Austin ran that much ARCA, but Ty did, and he won the championship, won 8 or 9 races 1 year. And they built their own. Nothing was given to them. They had to earn it. And I told them going in, if you guys can't go out and do it, you're not just going to go out there and race. So they've worked hard. They work as hard as any drivers I know preparing for a race. Well, they would come over to race shop when Dale would be over here working on something or hanging out, and they'd run over and pick and play and kid, and Dale would take one of them and push them down the deal on the creeper or something back in the day, or one of the stools, you know. They were always picking and playing together. So I think they knew how important Dale Earnhardt was in a race car and what he meant, even at a young age. Well, even on Dale's Bandolera car, he says, Pop, I want to use that 3. I said, you know, that's an important number. That's Dale Earnhardt's number. He said, no, that was your number. That's the reason I want to run it. So that's bringing it back and talking to Johnny Morris, a really good personal friend. We discussed bringing it back and bringing it back on the truck. And Johnny's a big 3 fan. He always has been an Earnhardt, a big 3 fan. And for us to be able to go out and win the championship for him in the truck, that meant a lot to us. And for Ty to win the championship, I used to drive an old modified car, number 41, and Ty to go win the championship, that meant a lot to me personally. Well, you know, the pride as a grandfather was there, but to know that they had accomplished what they had set out to do meant a lot to me, to watch both of them be able to celebrate championships and know that they went out and they worked hard enough and put enough into it. You can have good cars, and I've seen a lot of drivers in a lot of good cars that just took it for granted and weren't successful. Both of these guys work hard and work hard today to be successful. You know, I think winning the World 600 with Austin, that was one of the biggest wins you think you could ever have in your career. It's one of the big 3 as far as when I look at the 3 races you want to win. It should be 4 counting Darlington, Indianapolis, Daytona, and Charlotte. But to win it and win it with my grandson, and Austin always gets around Charlotte good, and be able to pull it off and win that race that night, it was a lot of emotion to see it happen. Yeah, you know, and like I said, winning Charlotte, you think it's the biggest race you're going to win when you win a World 600. But to follow it back up the following year with a Daytona 500 win, a last lap like Dale's win was, it was a caution on the last lap. There was some crashing going on, and I think Austin might have been right in the middle of it. But to come around, and when I seen him come around, when he came by for the white flag, I had a friend of mine, Earl Bentz, there. I said, Earl, it's going to be one hell of a wreck, or we're going to win the race. And sure enough, there was a wreck, and we won the race. So that was great. You know, speaking of family, when you think of NASCAR, I think of family. NASCAR was created by the France family, and today it's ran by the France family. And it's always had the family atmosphere in racing. You see a lot of kids. But for RCR, I started out, my wife was helping me back when I was running old cars at Bowman Gray Stadium, and she worked in office. She's worked here for 50 some years, longer than 50 years. She was working for me before we ever hit 69. And then my daughter worked for me. She still works for us more like a consultant today. And we have Austin and Ty, Mike Dillon, he's over our business development area. So it's still a family operation, and I'm really proud. And you know, nothing lasts forever. One of these days when I'm gone, I'd like to see them take it and carry it to the next level.